We are here, bazalwane, namhlanje siphethe i-topic ethi is what is happening outside. God's wrath yinqumbo kaThixo na, okanye is it the judgment yet? So I've got two apostle u prophet spa oho from the Jesus Christ Apocalypse Fellowship Center here in Queenstown is one of the great men of God here that is rising up. The Lord is using him mightily. Is one of the ministers I trust when it comes to the word of God and the biblical doctrine.
You know, Paul was got Genesis chapter 18 to chapter 19.
Yes.
Do you remember Moses Tiko says the fools will destroy Sodom and Gomorrah? You understand?
Yeah.
But Tiko para ngozo kwenza akandiqale liyo kwazi somhlobo wami uAbraham. You understand? Uthe wazivezo ndaba uAbraham, what hey Tiko ndicela ubuza manje. If ungafumana ukuthi amalungisa ay 50 pa ungay destroy, but Tiko answers. What about 40? What answers? What about 30? Souls 20 souls. What about 10? What answers? But still na clo 10. UThixo akazange akwazi ukudestroy iSodom neGomorrah because of one righteous person wayephaya igama lakhe yayinguLot.
Yes.
Because uGenesis chapter 19 verse 22 uyayiprova. Zide zidingelosi Lot ekhawuleza uphume because uselapha angeze ndikwazi ukulidestroya eli hlabathi. You understand? But that was prophetic because the Old Testament iBhayibhile izizona ezivezisithunzi sento yamanyanyana because uThixo wayengakhangeli ubulungisa babantu baninzi but wayekhangela ubulungisa bomntu omnye and loo mntu sithetha ngaye nguYesu Kristu. Because of Jesus Christ the world can't be destroyed. But ikwemali namhlanje ayiphelelanga nje kuYesu Kristu. Yesu yena buqu, he has given us his righteousness. So there's not only just one person who is righteous, but we are made the righteousness of God. So we are the sweet aroma of God here on this earth. So because of us, the earth, the world can't be destroyed because of the righteousness of God that is here on earth. So it is because of us. Thina benziweyo amalungisa. Uzaphinda buza umuntu, man of God, kuthe usena uconvinced. What about the judgment eku Elijah? Where Elijah would call upon the fire of God to consume people. You understand? He was the man who hated wickedness. You have man? But let us learn something in the New Testament.
Yes.
Because the Bible mosu Jesus before angene kwisixeko esiyokwenza crusade, wayethumela abafundi bakhe mosu eqala. So xa befika eSamaria, benkonqozela abantu bayizana na uYesu uzokwenza into enhle. Ini Bible zange kuphume nomnye umuntu. Ilibabela abafundi bakhe baba nomsindo bathi Jesu, how about we call upon the fire of God just like Elijah did to consume these wicked people.
Yes.
And they were rebuked by Jesus and he said, you people, you do not know what manner of spirit you are of. Because I have not come to judge the world but I have come to save it. So when it comes to the judgment fire of Elijah, uthi Jesu na not like Elijah. I'm not like Elijah. I'm not here to judge them. So nefnina nje nifuna judgment anizazi what manner of spirit you are of. And ibhlungu tatana namhlanje people are being preached to ngabantu who do not understand what manner of spirit they are of. But we are of the spirit of grace, spirit that seeks to save all who believe.
So wow, this epidemic will also pass.
Yes.
And and this planet Earth will remain.
Yeah.
This pandemic will pass. Yeah. It's not the end of the world.
That's right.
It's not God's wrath. It's not God's judgment. Because Christ says, I have not come
to destroy
or to judge the world.
To save.
But to save the world.
That's right.
Praise the Lord.
Wow.
So that means we as the church, I will always say this, we must always stand our ground.
Yeah.
As the church, we must not be carried away by what the world is saying or by the fear of the world. Instead, when the world is fearful of what is happening, we need to say to them, it's easy, you're not gonna die.
That's right.
Take Christ, make Christ your Lord and your Savior.
Wow.
Then that is it. So we don't have to present the kingdom of God by fear.
That's right, sir.
Like we're saying to people, repent, you shall die. This is hell. The end is coming. The world is coming to an end. The Lord is judging the world. And then people jump into salvation. out of fear.
Not of faith. Imagine.
Not of faith. Yeah. Out of fear. Now, what's happening when they wait and wait and wait for the judgment of the world? And the judgment of the world does not come. People will go back to their things because they say, now, man, this thing that we're told about, that we are going to be judged, we're going to be thrown into the pit of hell, it's not happening. So,
exactly.
Because they when the gospel of Christ was not presented to them out of love.
That's true, sir.
For the Bible says, for God so loved the world. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. That whoever believes in him might not perish, but have eternal life. My prophet.
Uthixo akabethi bantu, akanamsindo nabantu bakhe. You understand? So it's not the wrath of God, it's not the judgment of God. People should relax. Instead, we should ask God for mercy and cry for mercy because of this pandemic.
That was so sweet and wonderful. Thanks a lot, Apostle, with such an enlightening message, with such a powerful message that you have presented today as we have reached out to the world and trying to enlighten the saints that makungabikho koyika, mangabikho fear. The church must take its position. God bless you. We thank you. Thanks very much, Bazalwane, who was dealing with data and listen to us.